The Eventide Micropitch is a fine resolution pitch shifter for tone fattening, plus delays for dramatic slapback effects. In this review, we will go over the functions and sound of the micropitch so you know if this plugin is something for you. Hi, I'm Marlon and this is the White Noise Studio. Don't forget to like this video and subscribe to this channel, a channel to help you out in recording, mixing and mastering. Let's get right to the plugin. I will use this loop I'm working on as an example, and micropitch is on the DI'd guitar. Here is the guitar dry. And here is the micropitch in default setting. The layout is basically the same as with the crush station. It will probably be the same for every H9 which will be released. Check the review I did of the crush station here. Okay, the knobs, buttons and dials. Here we have the input control and here we have the output control volume. If we double click them, they will reset to zero. Here's the mix control, which sets the dry and wet amount. And here we have the pitch mix, which will set the balance between the A and B control pitch. The A pitch goes from unison to 50 cents up, and the B pitch goes from unison to 50 cents down. And with the pitch mix, you set the balance between those two voices. So with this, you can make it wider or really out of tune and wacky. Then we have a delay for voice A and voice B. So this one sets the delay for voice A. And this one sets the delay for voice B. And here's the tempo sync for delay. I had it on off, so I set the delay in milliseconds by hand. And you can switch it to manual, then the plugin will switch to 120 BPM and you set the note values over here. And you can set it to sync, then it syncs to the BPM of the project, which is 128 BPM, and then you set the note values. Then we go to the modulation depth and the modulation rate. Which will set the depth and rate of the modulation on the delay and pitch. The depth goes from 0 cents to twice the pitch you have set in the A and B voice pitch. With feedback, you set the amount of feedback for the delays. And tone is a filter you can set. These are the performance controls and you have an A and a B setting. The ribbon will morph between those two settings. Let's first make A a little bit less extreme and B more extreme, like this. And I will play a morph between the two settings so you can hear it. You can really perform with this ribbon, following the music, and you can automate it. You have three more buttons. Active is the bypass button. Flex is a nice one. When you press it, it will double the pitch of both voices. First, let's make these voices more extreme. And let's play. so you can get some real fun effects with this one. Here's Tap. When you are in manual mode, the default setting is 120 BPM, but if you press Tap, you can set the BPM off the manual mode. To whatever you want. You can actually also double click on the BPM and then set your BPM by typing it in. Let's play around with micro pitch a bit more on the guitar. The micro pitch can go from extreme delays, but it can also do some subtle things like a subtle chorus on drums. And let's insert it on drums. Here we are, default setting, drums and solo. And just load up a preset. Let's see, chorus and pitch, chorus room. So the micro pitch can also do extreme effects and subtle effects, which will be of benefit in a mix. The micro pitch can go from wacky delays to pretty subtle choruses, and with this ribbon you can apply those effects in a musical way while you mix as a performance. Thank you for watching this review of the Eventide micro pitch plugin. I also did a review of the Eventide Crush Station, and you can find it here. Don't forget to subscribe to this channel, and I'll see you next time. Bye!